Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit.
It's the Buck Bandit Podcast. It's the Buck Bandit Podcast. We in this. Yeah, you know what it is. We back here live on the Buck Bandit Podcast, episode 86.
86.
You already know.
Let's
season three. We back.
Season three.
We back. You know what I mean? But you know why you clicked on this, but before we get into it, I'll be your boy Buck Bandit Reno.
Your boy Buck Bandit P.
And make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that, man, because we bringing these bangers to you every effing week.
Every week. Hit that notification bell, baby.
Yeah. Bing. You already know. So we're going to get into this hot episode we got for you because there's a lot of things been going on this week, last week, and other weeks. You might have heard of it. You might not have.
Week on a week.
We here to bring it to you regardless. You know what I mean? And the first thing we want to talk about is this. Yeah, you know what it is, the kid, Buck Bandit Reno. And I'm here to let y'all know the opportunity is here, man. Buck Bandit Podcast Network now is a Buck Bandit Podcast Network. So if you out there, you looking to shoot your podcast, you don't got a place to shoot it. You don't got video equipment, video editor. You don't got audio equipment, audio editor, lights, microphones. Don't worry about none of that because we'll handle that. You know, hit me up at Buck Bandit Reno on Instagram or Buck Bandit Podcast on Instagram. And find out how you can get your own podcast here on the Buck Bandit Podcast Network, man. What are you waiting for? You in the house doing it? You still doing it off your phone? You doing lives? Forget all that. If you in the tri-state area, you in Philadelphia, come get your podcast shot here, man. Hit me up. Once again, at Buck Bandit Reno on Instagram, at Buck Bandit Podcast on Instagram, or you can email me at buckbanditstudio@gmail.com. Let's get it, man. Carlee Russell. Yeah, I mean, you know Jesse Smollett's sister. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh. What about her?
How she have all these people praying for her?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Bring her back home. Amber alerts. Mm-hmm. Come to find out, she was just hiding out. She wanted some attention.
Exactly. What kind of shit is this?
Faking abductions and shit.
What has the world come to? I mean,
y'all blame Jesse Smollett, man. He started
Nobody
tried really kidnapping themselves for attention until he did that shit.
Yeah, that's crazy. Like, motherfuckers was really outraged looking at the video. Like, oh no, look, she got took. You know
how many wasted prayers
like
went on them posts? You know what I'm saying?
Just goes to show how shit on the internet could be spread so fast that's not real.
Yeah.
Like somebody could fool the internet
that quick.
Yeah, you know I mean that fast.
Just go to a motel.
Like, yo, that shit is crazy.
That's crazy.
But I mean, honestly, if that was her plan to get famous, like it worked. Yeah, I mean, like, because though motherfuckers a hater, like, if she play her cards right, she could still, you mean, maybe do something.
What company going to endorse a liar?
She got to be a fucking,
it's gonna be
her
bad
own
for
business. She got to be her own
who
company.
Who going to buy that shit? She lying about it. Whatever it is, she lied about it. You know what I'm saying? It's not made from the material she said it was made from. You know what I'm saying?
She might
get
an interview or something. You know what I mean?
Yeah, why did you lie?
Yeah, because
I wanted
she might
attention.
Get an interview.
Now everybody, should we feel bad for her? No.
And that's the thing. That's why they can be like, all right, look, we're going to give you, you know what I mean, a couple stacks. You know what I mean? Literally a couple.
Do what?
One, two.
She ain't going to do nothing but disappear.
Look, no, just come on TV, you know what I mean, and say why you, you know what I mean, do an interview. And you know what I mean, we can ask you why you did it. And then she fade to black. She going to at least get one around.
$2,000.
Yeah, they going to give her one,
too. That ain't nothing. Boop, boop.
That's it. Right.
Because people like her, she probably would have got the traffic and it would have been a lot of hate if she would have kept her page up. But they usually take their page down so they ain't got to watch all that shit. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that's crazy. What's the overall about that? How you feel about that, though?
I mean, this is the whole thing, though. Like,
is it a mental problem or something?
Oh, yeah, it's definitely mental. Like, it's so
but
many
she had to
problems.
Plan that. It was more than just regular mental. You had
she
to.
She might not have planned it. She might have just been a spur of the moment type. Fuck it. I mean, I'm driving home from work, man. Fuck these motherfuckers. Man. You know what I mean? Like, that shit happened like that. Like, I'm they go miss from zero to 100. Like, just. Like, oh, bitch, calm the fuck down. What the
fuck? Yeah.
What just happened? So, it might have been that. You never know. So,
she just went crazy.
Yeah. Like, on some. I'm going to show these motherfuckers, I guess. I don't know who she was trying to show or what she was trying to prove. Or because when you do shit like that, you trying to prove something. You trying to show something. You know what I mean? Like, mostly anything you do, you trying to prove something.
What would you do if I was gone?
Like, come on. That shit weird. Like, that shit weird as shit. And when that shit happened, let's make a new... Like, whatever you try to lie and fucking... Whenever you try to lie on somebody and get them... arrested, when they find out that it was a lie, you should do the time that you
at least
whatever you lied on them about, you should do, I mean, right, at least half that time. Like, do whatever, go through that process. Like, the case should transfer over to you. You know what I mean? Whatever the consequences was, should automatically transfer over to you.
Yeah.
Because that'd be an incentive for people female, to stop lying. Females be fucking lying. Yeah, niggas be lying too. But I'm talking about the fake, like, niggas, think about the niggas who got booked for fake rape cases and all that shit. Mm. And that shit found to be not guilty. Like, it's just like, all right, that's it. And it's like, hold up, this bitch don't get probation, no lying counseling,
nothing.
Deception nothing. Detention. Like,
no.
Bitch don't get nothing. She just get to go do it to the next nigga. Like, fuck it, I ain't get him. I'm going to get the next one.
She
like,
already did it to three, like, four other people.
Yo,
probably.
Like, that shit is fucked up. Like, that shit is a fucking sickness.
Yeah, you don't have to. You don't have to serve any consequences for playing a victim.
Yeah, like
the only person who did was Jesse Smollett. You know,
right, that's it.
Nobody else really suffered consequences.
She might though. She might, but I don't know.
How?
I was just ready to say
they gonna go after her for money she ain't got.
I was ready to say, but if she got lawyers, they can beat that case. Like Jesse Smollett, he literally lied. She ain't never come out and be like, yo, I got kidnapped, this, that, and the third. Like, she manipulated some shit and made it look like it's something that it was. You know what I mean?
Nah,
she could say whatever. Nah, you know what I mean?
She made a lawyer it look like it.
It's more what I'm saying, it's more reasonable doubt in that situation. She didn't come out and say, yeah, I got kidnapped, this person, and I got away. Like, she never did that. She insinuated a lot of shit. So that's wiggle room. You know what I mean? Jesse Smollett was like, these niggas came up. They did this. They tried to rape me. They robbed me. Like, dog, come on, bro.
It was two white guys.
It was the coldest night in Chicago that night, but they tried to, like, they're like, come on, dog. Like,
yeah, I understand where you're getting at. But I mean, I'm just saying, at the end of the day, like you said, whoever accused somebody of something should serve the consequences for half the time for what they accused the other person of. If it was a heinous crime, you know what I mean? Like, if you say, I seen him do it.
Right.
Like,
lying,
yeah.
Right.
You
like
need
that.
To serve that time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because it don't make sense for people to not have to serve any consequences for just lying.
Lying.
You know what I mean? And people really be losing years of their life for that shit. Niggas getting out for 30, 40 years.
Jail.
Lose their family.
I was just trying to say, kids grow up, all kind of shit.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, that'd be something we definitely should put out there, though.
They definitely should change that.
And Carlee Russell, you a dickhead of the day. You know how they got donkey today? We got dickhead of the day.
Dickhead.
He's a dickhead. You know what I mean? All them wasted prayers. You know what I mean?
Right.
And speaking of people that's fucked up, Hassan Campbell. Do you know who that is?
No, who is
the boy always talking about got your snap box rocked and all that shit?
No.
All right, he was he got his booty played with. He came out and said he got his booty played with from African Bambaataa.
Mm-hmm.
You remember?
Mm-hmm.
You remember now? So the nigga came out basically dissing Gillie after Gillie's son, rest in peace, Cheese, died. You know what I'm saying? Talking about how you rich and you ain't get your kids out the hood and all this other bullshit. Like, the nigga, the nigga got a crib. The nigga got money. If the motherfucker want to go hang out where he hang out, that's where he going to hang out. You know what I mean? He grown at the end of the day. But why would you come out and, like, speak negative on You know what I mean?
You know why? Because some people just...
do anything for click.
Exactly. Some people just will fucking go to the lowest of lows just to fucking try to get some fame or get some clout or some money or just whatever. Like, notoriety. And that shit is bullshit. Like, that shit is clout chasing at its lowest form. Like, it's fucking bottom feeding type shit. Like, type energy.
Yo, he need to take that shit down.
Yeah, I hate that type shit. Like, that type shit, it just bothers me. Like, even if you feel that type of way, why would you even say that? Like, you ain't doing that. Like, you literally doing that trying to get fucking clout off of somebody deaf. Like, you want to get air. That's what it is. Like, and I don't even want to say, like, that's the last time I'm going to say that. But, yeah, you tripping. You can't.
It's just some shit you don't do.
Like, dead son. Yeah.
It's just shit you don't do. And the shit just happened. Yeah.
Nigga. You better hope I don't run into you. Ever. Okay, I see you in 2079. Oh, yeah, that's that nigga right there.
Nigga. Yeah, right. Hold this shit. Slap the shit out you out your wheelchair, nigga. Bow.
I ain't letting it go. For a fact,
it's just certain lines you don't cross, and like you really doing that for some clicks. You already got followers, so I don't know why you just doing extra nut shit for clicks, like
to keep their views up. Everything about the views, the likes, the shares, shit is drug. The follows. It's a drug, bro. Yeah, exactly.
We talk about shit, but if we had to, like, defame somebody or diminish somebody's character every week, then I couldn't do it. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not even
it ain't that deep. Yeah. It ain't that deep. That shit will go a whole nother angle. This shit will be all positive shit, make fun of, like, 3-4 niggas and then keep that shit move like...
But if a nigga came at us, then definitely I would go hard. I mean, if every a nigga
came at me, I ain't mean, fucking.
No, it all depend who if it we is. Getting views from it, fuck it.
I was just saying, it all depends. That's what I said. It all depends who it is. If it's just little
Ray Ray.
Pookie and Ray Ray and them.
Yeah.
Whatever. Well, but if somebody come at me that's worth going, oh yeah, then yeah.
Oh yeah. I'm going to get my bread from it.
They come at you and all that, oh yeah.
I'm going to get my shit from it.
I'm going in.
You know what I'm saying?
Going in. But yeah, no, that shit nutty. I'm never fucking talking about a nigga. Even if I don't fuck with a nigga and his cousin, sister, brother, kid, like, die. Not even any of the, like, your kid die. That's like worse than nigga wife or husband. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, your kid is like little
you. They supposed
to
bury
like,
you.
Right, you know what I mean? Like, that's your heart, your soul. Like, nigga, I will fucking earth you. He's tripping. Yeah, he
trouble. Yeah, shout out to Gillie and Wallo.
Yeah,
rest in peace, Cheese. For sure. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
That was crazy. You know what I mean?
And niggas speak on shit they don't know about. Like he shouldn't be living in the hood. Who said he live in the hood? Cause them niggas definitely don't live in no fucking hood.
Facts.
Niggas, what the fuck is he talking about?
No, niggas just saying anything. It was a triple, like a triple homicide or some shit. So he was just around niggas. You know what I mean? But once again, rest in peace. And the nigga Hassan Campbell, he really deserved an ass whooping. Grade A.
Grade A, Jane.
Sort of like the ass whooping that we predicted that was going to happen. And
what's that?
Spence versus Crawford.
Oh, for sure. Spence versus Crawford.
Now... I made you give an explanation on why you thought, and we definitely said because.
Oh, so what you running that back right now as we speak?
No, I don't have to. I don't have to because I remember everything. So it's like, we said basically, huh?
So what I say?
Well, you said because he butted. He going to win because he butted. That's
I
it.
Say that.
And I tried to make you elaborate.
That. I ain't say
no,
that.
You was like, he going to win because he butted, nigga.
I ain't say that.
That's what he is. He butted. That's what he do. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, but elaborate. Why?
And then what I said.
And then, you know what I'm saying? You were saying because basically his IQ shit.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? And I was like, because he could dip and dodge punches while he on the inside.
I see you know a better saying? Boxer than him. I see he's a better boxer. And he, what he do? He outboxed him.
And he wasn't
first
getting
round,
hit.
He lost the first round.
No, you know what? I think the first round was a draw because none of them was really throwing punches.
Yeah,
they
he
both
lost
was
the
laning.
No, he lost the first round. Absolutely.
No, it wasn't a clear cut loss.
No.
No, he lost the first round because he didn't throw no punches.
Yeah, he was filling him out.
Exactly.
Then second round on.
Errol Spence
landed. He knocked him down in the second round, and then after that, it was over.
After the first round, it was over. But what I'm saying is he lost the first round. Like, he came out and
he was filling him out.
Downloaded data. Yeah, like, hell yeah. I mean, like, he really, like, boxed. Like I said, like you said, his IQ and his motherfucking, like, he's a better boxer than Earl. You know what I mean? And Earl couldn't hit him. Like, Earl hit hard, but he couldn't hit him. So it didn't matter how hard you hit if you can't hit what you're trying to fucking hit.
Right.
He just kept getting tired. And the thing about it is, Crawford was so much of a better boxer than him.
Yeah.
When he dropped him with a jab. Like, he dropped him, but just because his footwork was better. Because they said Earl like to rush in with the, he do something when he come in.
Throw,
and
he just throw a whole bunch of punches. That's his thing.
He come forward with that lunge with that right leg or something. And Crawford knew that. So, I mean, you peep how when he tried to do that bullshit, he came for boop. Drop the shit out of him with a jab, like, just because he's a better boxer. Like, so, man, ain't nobody fucking with Terrence Crawford. He ain't gonna be no Floyd really Mayweather, but he might go.
All the talk I heard about Spence and the fights I seen with Spence, Terrence Crawford made him look like he was almost like an amateur.
Like, look like he
how you got three belts and he only got one. And y'all kept saying he ain't fight nobody, and none of his fights was close. He just made him look like nobody.
Exactly.
Even the Errol Spence fight, that shit wasn't even close, bro.
Not at all.
It wasn't even close.
He won the first round and that's it. Just because Bud only threw like fucking 10 punches or something. Because he was just like, all right, let me see how he fight.
But I knew Bud was going to win, though. Because I said, fuck it, I go for Errol Spence to make it crazy.
No, you did say Errol Spence.
I say after that? I said, I'm going to be that nigga in the locker room. Like, damn, man, I hope you lose, dog. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I knew he was going to lose because Bud is that nigga. But I ain't want to feel biased on the clips. I know when this shit get out and the clips get out, it's going to look like everybody on it. See what I mean? So I wanted to do a phony-ass first take clip real quick. Excuse me for being fake for 1 week.
None of that. The real going to prevail.
But
see
I did
happens?
Say I would be in his locker room telling him I'm rooting for the other nigga. You know, I did say that.
You was going to be in his locker room, so y'all was going to be on home together. No partying for y'all, nigga.
No, it's partying for me because I got in for you. You got a plus one always. Like, oh, so you saying you're not going to bring me? Exactly. Because you know we both agree. I just didn't want nobody to feel left out. A nigga ain't gonna come for the interview if we only, like, you know what I mean, talking about the other nigga.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Bam. I want to get both sides of the story.
I mean,
but
he
after
did make
that
it
second
to the
nigga
ninth,
leave,
though.
I'm gonna definitely be like, oh yeah,
yeah.
But.
But yeah, he definitely did make it to the ninth, though. But after, like, the seventh, I was like,
nah,
oh, yeah,
barely.
This ain't gonna last too much.
Barely.
And
the seventh, I was like, we was in the club. In the seventh, I was like, yo, why don't they just throw in the towel, yo? And the boy behind me was like, yo, how would they look like if they did that? I said, how would it look like if he got knocked out or the ref stop it?
Yeah.
Throw in the towel. Go back to the drawing board.
Yeah, this ain't working. And niggas talking about a rematch. I don't think Earl wanted with him.
He shouldn't.
It is a
you
clause,
shouldn't. Listen,
isn't it?
Earl,
like, if
don't
Earl
do it.
Wanted,
move
he
up.
Get, if
move
Earl wanted, he get the rematch. But I don't think he won it with him.
It don't make sense.
Yeah, I was just
trying to
say, honestly, it don't make sense. You ain't going to go train for fucking 8-9 months and come 10 months and be fucking better than you. Like, you're not going to be able to beat
him. How much better? Well, what you going to change?
Yeah,
really?
Exactly. You're not going to be able to beat him in 10 months. In 10 months, imagine where he going to be.
There's nothing really he can do.
Nothing.
Because his go-to is, coming forward, throwing punches. Coming forward, throwing punches. But what happens when you coming forward, throwing punches, and ain't nothing connected? Mm-hmm. So he ain't going to magically get a new boxing style and start dipping and dodging and counter punching, because that's not what he do.
Ducking my moms and shit.
You know what I mean? So I think Errol Spence, he the best boxer right now.
Errol Spence?
I mean, I'm sorry. Yeah. Terrence Crawford is the best boxer right now.
Exactly. He is. He is. He ain't going to go, 49-50-0 like Floyd.
He
but
might.
He fuck around and go
he
undefeated.
He might. If he don't move up and he just stay where he at.
He gonna go. He might go undefeated. He ain't going to get 49-50 wins. He going
to
retire.
You think he going to go to another weight class and win another belt?
If he go to another weight class, I don't like him in another weight class.
If he move up to fight Errol Spence, then that's another weight class he can try to.
I was just trying to say, now that fight makes sense.
Now if they run a rematch, but at 154, and if he win, you take the belt there.
Yeah.
All exactly. The belts there.
All the belts, just trying to say, all the belts. But no, but like, I don't like that. Honestly. Wow. I put that in Spence's favor. If he move up, what, the 154? That's what it is?
But he still, his them game plan is pounds, to come forward and punch. You still got to hit the nigga.
Them 7 pounds is a lot, though.
But it only matters if you hit the nigga.
Yeah. Oh, you going to get hit. It's going to be hard to move.
Yo, did you see what Terrance Crawford looked like when he came out the fight?
He wasn't 154,
he looked like he
though.
Was ready to go into the fight.
He wasn't 154, though.
So you saying, ten more pounds he gonna be slower?
Yeah, it's fucking math. It's physics, not math.
Just
it's
10 pounds, physics. He gonna be so it's much slower physics. That he can't dip a punch.
No, he gonna be able to. I ain't gonna say. All right,
so
saying
I'm
that.
Saying. So how is Spence Jr. gonna work if he counter punching you, your bull rushing?
At 154, I like Errol Spence. I'm not gonna lie. At 154, I like Errol. Cause Bud ain't going. Even though, but I ain't gonna lie, it was at one point where fucking Errol Spence tried even to hit push. Him. He tried to push Bud, and Bud just stood there. That, yeah. And then Bud pushed him,
so
and he
Bud,
was like,
"So
was
Bud like, oh, gained more weight, and they both got to gain more weight." Come on, dog. Bud already
it
that
did,
much stronger than
did
him.
Did look crazy.
Come on, bro.
It did look crazy.
Bud yeah. got it.
Yeah. No.
So what you think? He gonna stay? Up. He gonna stay at this weight, or he gonna move up?
Somebody gonna knock Bud the fuck out, bro. I'm trying to tell you, it's not.
But he, you forgetting he going to be 154, too.
Yeah, I'm not forgetting it, but I don't like Bud at 154.
Well, listen, what do you think like he going to do then? Is he going
to
stay
he
at this
have
weight?
He going to stay at, yeah. Why not? Stay the champ.
What other fights
stay
is
the
there?
Champ, dog.
Besides Boots.
I don't know. Somebody going to come.
Boots.
Yeah.
Boots Ennis.
Ain't nobody.
That's the last person. Or Charlo.
Ain't nobody.
Money might be in one of the twin Charlo fights.
It's going
to
be somebody eventually. He should just chill.
Jaren Boots Ennis. I
wouldn't
can see
fight
that.
Nobody at least until like 2025 if I was Terrance Crawford. I mean, just
what?
To chill. Just to chill and
two,
fucking.
Take 2 years off? They're
yeah.
not going to let you do that.
Yeah. What?
It's probably a year tops.
That's what I'm saying. It's a year. It's 2024. Well, it's 2023. By the time you fight again, it's going to be, end of 2025. Yeah.
No.
I'm trying to tell you, dog. That's what I would do.
You
so
tell
then
him
you
to
could,
milk.
Yeah.
You tell him to milk the United.
Because then you, listen, then
they
you stay
make
at
him
the weight.
Joints up.
And everybody going to be trying to, get at the motherfucking the throne.
You want to,
everybody going to want the belts. So somebody going to merge and they going to be like, oh, this who Terrance Crawford running from. You know how I go. Oh, this the fight he been ducking all the whole time and all that. And then it's going to be some other bull. And he going to fucking come fight Terrance Crawford. And Terrance Crawford going to beat him. And then.
But you talking about imaginary people.
It's going to keep
I'm talking about the fights that he could make now that could possibly make money.
He not.
That's the twin Charlo. Or fucking Boots Ennis. That's where that's the last two. You be both of them, then you could talk about what you're saying.
Well, we'll see. Either way, I like.
Unless
Bud,
he gonna move up now.
If as long as he don't move up, he move up, he's done. A done bun.
So you don't got no. So you don't really got faith in him.
Oh yeah, I got faith in him all day. At 147.
You just only had faith in him versus Spence.
I got faith in him at 147.
I thought you was a Bud. Yeah. I thought you was a Bud enthusiast. Enthusiast or
the fuck out of
it. Info,
I'm a
info.
Bud enthusiast. The fuck out of it.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he's a fucking Earl sexual, nigga. Fuck out of it. Yeah.
I didn't think Earl was
you said, yo, I'm gonna be in Earl locker room with him, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Betting on Bud.
Fuck
that's my exact words.
Fuck out of it.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I mean? Just, you know what I mean? Most people don't know shit about boxing. You know what I mean? It's
yeah,
cool.
I know, I know. Yeah, all I do is say the same thing twice. You got it. You know what I'm saying? But we're gonna keep it moving. And we're going to talk about PX girlfriend. You know who that is.
What up, y'all? This your girl, Charlie Baltimore. We down here with my homeboy, Buck Bandit TV. You know how we do. We making them hits in here. Y'all need to come through. I let your girl.
You know what it is, Buck Bandit Studio. $50 an hour, mix and mastering included. Let's work, baby.
Lizzo.
Oh, yeah. What's up, baby?
We're going to talk about your boo, man.
Mm-hmm, that's my baby.
Well, what's up with her work environment? What you heard about that?
I don't know, man. I heard that it's going down in her camp. You know what I mean? The people, you know what I mean? Backup dances and all that. They said, listen, this work environment is horrible. You know what I mean? You got sexual harassment going on. Lizzo in there acting diva. You know what I mean?
She calling fat shaming.
She calling fat bitches, yeah. She's going in, like, I was like, yo, this is appalling, like, I didn't know it was going down like that, so she getting sued for millions, I don't know how much it is, but that's word on the street.
I don't think they gonna get nothing, though.
I don't know, it's the Me Too is strong, they came for her.
Well, if we judging by equal standards, since Spears is a fat guy and he called her fat and they trying to cancel him, she a fat girl and she calling another fat girl fat, they should cancel her too.
Yeah. It's motherfucking
equal.
Yeah, no. I mean, that would be nice if that would happen, but
I mean, that's what should happen.
That ain't gonna happen. It's the feminism movement. They could do whatever. Like we were just talking about, they could lie. They could do whatever.
It's
cool when they
do it. It's a problem when I do it.
Exactly. So, you know what I mean? Fuck it. Don't be, you know what I mean? Mad. Fat bitches could call fat bitches. But you can't call a fat bitch because you ain't a fat bitch. That's just how it goes.
But the person that called her a fat bitch is a fat bitch ass nigga. So,
well, if the person that called her a fat bitch is a fat bitch ass nigga, then that fat bitch would know that, all right, I'm a fat bitch. Because it's a fat bitch ass
well,
nigga.
Well, no, he got
so
canceled.
So he would know. You know what I mean? So
he got canceled.
I mean, that's because he ain't really.
He ain't got no motherfucking outlet. That's why.
He ain't got more star power than
you. Gotta have your own outlets out here,
Lizzo,
nigga.
Lizzo got fans.
We do this shit because we want to do it, not because we got to do it. Yeah. That's the difference.
Yeah.
A lot of niggas in here trying to make a way, trying to be popular. Nigga, I've been popular. Yeah, I could be in all the circles popular. That y'all niggas want to be in. I'm just not a dick eater.
Yeah, man, like that shit ain't cool. That shit ain't never been cool.
I add value to a room. You know what I'm saying? Some niggas don't add value to the room.
They just want
to
be in the room.
That's when people talk to you any type of way. That's when the Lizzo can call you names and shit because you're not adding value to the motherfucking room.
Exactly.
You're just another person.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Because guaranteed, the people who add value to the room, she not talking to them like that.
Mm-hmm. Right. Exactly. She ain't talking to everybody like that. That's a fact. And everybody
so instead of trying to cancel
ain't
her,
treated like
how
that.
About look within yourself and see soul why you're working for somebody who think you a fat bitch? I mean, look at yourself.
Look within yourself.
At some point, you got to look in the mirror because no job I ever had, a boss talked to me like that and got away with it.
Just scot free, like.
You know what I mean?
You have to see me about that, nigga.
So maybe you should stop being fanatics and work at a job that you really love and do what you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Do what you destined to do.
Right. Exactly.
Cause when a Lizzo could call you fat, you working the wrong you working the wrong motherfucking job.
Or maybe they was bigger than her.
That's crazy. Maybe she was just hiring people bigger than her just so she could do that.
Right. So now yeah.
What work they getting done though? Exactly. They bigger than her. What fucking work is really getting done?
All virtual assistant work and computer work and virtual work, nigga. I mean, everything on the computer. Fuck you mean?
No, if she can walk, you know, so she walking in the office like boom.
Yo, fat bitches. No, they was working from home. She used to pop up at their crib.
She pop up with a line. Yeah. Boop, a conference call.
Bitch, I'm outside. Come over the fucking door. Fuck wrong with y'all.
Yeah, that's crazy. But shout out to all the workers, man. Hopefully y'all get a new job. And suing her, you're not going to get another job in the industry.
You're done. You're done.
You know what I mean? So you might. It's a done button. You know what I mean? Lizzo, you got to lighten up because you don't like when people snapping on you. So you got to be a little bit nicer. Yeah. Just a little bit.
Talk to me nice.
Talk to him nice. You know what I mean? And this last thing I wanted to talk about.
What's that?
If you have something else, you know what I mean? We could talk about that. But Florida rapper 350 Heem. We don't know who he is. There's a lot of rappers out here, so I ain't going to disrespect and act like he don't got a following. Because he had an album release party, but the nigga got shot and killed at his album release party. What the fuck is going on?
Damn, son. That shit is fucked up. Where the fuck was it at? Where you said
from? I'm not sure.
Florida? Oh, I don't know why.
Yeah, Florida. Florida rapper, so yeah. He did say Florida. Somewhere in Florida.
Damn, it goes down in Florida. Damn, you think them niggas got palm trees, they be cool, like, in nice weather. Like, what the fuck is we gangbanging for, B? Like,
why the niggas showed, they knew he was going to be at the album release party. They showed up, you know what I mean?
But then again,
it must have been some ops. He was about to drop some fire shit. But it's crazy. You can sum it up to certain shit, but you don't really know what it is. Like,
I was just ready to say. I was just about to say that shit. Like, and I don't want to be that guy. But it's like, all right. But what did he do in order for them? Like, he might have did nothing. But like, what's the story? Like, we don't know the story. We just know the result of what happened. Like, what was the album about? Was the album on some crazy shit? Like, was it? You know what I mean? What was that really? His ops? Was it his? You know what I mean? Somebody who is
dumbass argument.
Right. You know what I mean? Friend turn foe. Like, it's so many fucking options that it just be hard to
pinpoint. Look.
Yeah, it just be hard to see something on the internet and be like, oh shit, like, this is definitely what happened. So,
but I think that's what they want.
Right.
To desensitize people.
Right.
So you won't feel for somebody when shit like that happened.
Exactly.
Because you calling them a rapper from a specific place in his rapper name.
He might have been a dad. He might have been a little brother. He was definitely somebody's son. You know what I mean? So it's like, he might have been a big brother. Like, you never know who. Like, so it's just, like you said, it's desensitizing motherfuckers. But at the same time, it's kind of like giving motherfuckers a warning. Like, yo, this shit could, like, this shit is could be so much better if motherfuckers
at
just.
Any moment, man.
Yeah. If motherfuckers just realize, like, yo, this shit is deeper than just me getting mad at somebody because whatever, or me out here doing this nut shit. Like, that shit ain't worth it.
Like, people throw away their life. Just to you take somebody else's life, you really throw away your life.
Because
you're going to get caught at some point.
Yeah.
Whether it's by, like, the law or whether it's by, like, the other people who retaliate.
Yeah.
You can't go on forever. You know what I mean?
Definitely can't. And it's karma is a bitch. That shit always come around. Karma is a bitch. So it's like.
Now I don't know what he did. He might have did shit.
Right. I was just trying to say.
I ain't
going
to put no smut on his name.
Say it. But even
but
like.
You never know.
I don't like to see, you know what I mean, motherfuckers getting mad and killing motherfuckers.
Somebody in their face in front of their girl or something. Right.
And I still feel sorry that he got killed.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Like, it's fucked up all the way around. Like, we got to. Have emotional
better,
intelligence,
man.
Straight up.
We gotta do better.
Each other.
If anything, pull up on him and fight him or some shit.
Yeah,
at least niggas can come back from that. You can come back from a squabble.
Pull up with the gloves. I remember niggas used to do that.
Pull up and throw gloves. We should do a skit. Yeah. Just pull up on the nigga that you got beef with and throw gloves.
Throw gloves. Yeah. What's up, pussy?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I like that.
But shout out to Heem. 350 Heem. Rest in peace. You know what I'm saying? Another rapper gone.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? There's a lot of them this year.
Yeah. The good die young. It's been a lot every year for the past couple years now. It's like rapping is the most dangerous motherfucking. Like,
occupation.
Yeah.
Yep.
The fuck? God damn.
You got rap. You got. If it's like if you rap, things you got to count on happening is somebody trying to rob you for your jewelry if you out. You know what I'm saying?
The cops trying to hate on you.
The cops trying to pull you over for whatever. Fucking getting killed in your hometown.
the businessman trying to fucking rape you, the agent or the label or, you know what I mean? Like, taxes. It's so many fucking shit. Addictions. Like, it's so many bitches. Like, it's so much shit. Like,
so before many
you
devils.
Get, it's so many distractions before you gotta can be understand. Like, it's like hurdles and fucking obstacles, dog. And that shit is not by accident.
Yeah.
It ain't by accident.
And the crazy part is if you don't catch on to it fast, then all that shit can really consume you and shit. You really fall into all that shit. Really be thinking you something you're not. And the moment you stop and get off your game and all that shit disappear, niggas, that's when niggas be wanting to commit suicide. Because they don't know how to get back to the work.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly. That's
how
I mean.
How I get back to where people like me again.
Right. Get it's back like, to being the bull. Get back to being that bitch. Or get back to, you know what I mean? Just being whatever. Motherfuckers do anything.
But yeah, to end this on a lighter note though.
For sure.
We never talked about Fat Joe moment.
On
ESPN or whatever that was. When he was talking about a basketball player named Grady Dick.
Hey.
Grady Dick, that's his name. Pause.
Hey, you.
But instead of saying he like Grady from Kansas, the nigga said he like Dick from Kansas.
Hey, you.
Pause.
Brother.
A to the motherfucking yo.
So let me get this straight. Fat Joe said he like what?
He like A yo from Kansas.
Yo, he got a chill. He ain't say that.
He said chill. It.
Yeah.
Live, too.
That's fucked up. Because he didn't mean that.
No,
Fat
he
meant. Joe a real one. It, he
it was
mean
two
that.
Names that he could have used. That. Grady and Dick. Why would he ain't say, why he ain't just say, I like Grady from Kansas?
Man, listen, because he was. Yeah, he tripping. Why did?
Because it's not like he said he like Dick, and then he like the specific place he liked Dick from.
Once you say it like that, I mean, it's kind of
like Dick from Kansas. Like that's the place to get Dick from.
I mean, don't he play for Kansas? So that is the place to get the ball from. I said the ball. I ain't no bar shit. Like I would never call a grown man. Like that's just not there. Like what the fuck? But then ain't that the nickname of Richard or something? They call him like.
Nah,
Ayo.
I ain't trying to hit it. That's his last name.
Yeah.
But if you're saying on live TV that you
his
like
last
him.
Last name ain't. How you spell it?
D-I-C-K, nigga.
No.
That's how you spell it. That's his name. So just use his first name when you're talking to him. What was so funny? The fact that I spelled it?
You spell it. You gotta be capping, dog.
No.
You don't spell his name.
Yes, it is.
That's D-I-C. D-I-C-C. Yes,
no.
Deek.
No, that's not Dick. That's Deek. And if he said that, that still would have been pause and AO too. I like Deek from Kansas. Hey, yo, what is you saying? Dick French? Nigga? What is that? Dick in French?
Fuck you talking about.
Freak ass old head. Yeah. No, but that's funny as shit. Shout out to Fat Joe, man. You got it. Even if you say you don't play the pause game, nigga, you never
Joe.
Out the game. You can't say shit like
as
that.
As long as you living, you just
you in the
game.
EA Sports, nigga.
You ain't got to log in. You ain't got to do none of that. That nigga
Fat Joe
chill.
Tripping, though.
Yeah, he should have just said. He should have just said his other name. He not going to call him or say the young boy or say. Yeah, the youngin', the guard, the forward.
He was on the show with white people, so he probably felt comfortable. Like,
oh yeah, this is my chance to say some gay.
No, not like that.
As you said, Fat Joe was like,
he might have forgot his first name and just remembered Dick. I'm just trying to give him the benefit of the doubt, man.
He just
I can't believe OG. Yeah. That's how he remembered. That's how he remembered. That's the only that's the only thing I can come up with. He didn't mean it, but he meant it because he couldn't remember his first name.
He said so he just remembers his dick.
Yeah. You never forget dick. Yo. Like everybody know at the end of that show, when the last name pop up, it's a Dick Wolf. Everybody remember that. Which show is that? It's either Law and Order or some shit like that.
Yeah, it's Law and Order.
Because you remember Dick Wolf. Because Dick is in there. Anytime you put the dicks on it, you go, it's rememberable. That's why you, yeah, that's why I be getting these bitches. You know what I'm saying? It's just rememberable. That's all I'm saying.
What's up with that? Law and Order? I'm like, yeah, what the fuck did I get? Yeah, got dick in
it. You remember that shit, though? Yeah. Shit. I ain't lying.
Oh, my God. Yo, this nigga is retarded.
You remember that shit, though? Am I lying?
Yeah, man.
Come on, bro.
Fuck you. Don't give me a grief.
This is how everybody at a certain age remember that little, that company joint when it come up and the little kid sitting on it and they say, Deek. Everybody at a certain age remember that shit. You know what I'm saying? Because it was the dick in it. It was the D-I-C. Remember that shit.
So basically, anytime you put dick in it, that shit is just make it better. You know what I mean?
That's why I be telling these bitches. But they don't be listening to me all the time.
Man. Y'all got to listen, man.
Y'all bitches got to listen. Yo. So when you put the dick in it, everything is better.
You already know.
For like, the female. Better pause. The not for men.
Right, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? No Never. Disrespect. If you live your life, how you live your life.
Yeah.
I just ain't that.
Oh, my goodness. Ooh, well, this has been a good episode.
Yeah.
That was funny as shit.
You ever see that story, the boy YNW Melly? The nigga that's
on
trial
that
for, like, killing his two best friends and
that's
shit.
That's what he on trial for?
Yeah.
He killed his two best friends? Why do people want him to get off so bad then?
He trying to say he innocent, but he not saying who did it. NLE came out, NLE Choppa came out with a video reenacting it.
So NLE Choppa, that's his homie or they from the
same
hood?
I don't
know.
I think he's just a rapper that fucked with him.
Okay. But he reenacted it on
the
Bull
music
behalf.
Video. Yeah. Because the Bull, if you look at the case, he was on the left side. And the Bull, NLE Choppa reenacted it with himself on the right side. Like, you gotta be into the case to know all that shit, but he just he did a little joint that just came out. But you know, he got off. I guess it was a mistrial. Now they trying to retrial him again. Like, they trying to get him out of here.
Damn.
He killed both them niggas. That's what they trying to say. He saying he didn't, but he ain't saying who did.
What you think happened? You think he ain't do it, but he know who did, and he just ain't ratting? Or
yeah,
you think he really did it?
Yeah.
You think he just know who did it?
Yeah, I think he was sitting next to who did it.
I was just ready to say, if he ain't do it, then
if he ain't do it,
he know somebody.
But he did it. He either did it or he know the nigga who did it.
So which mean he did it anyway, because he probably ordered it. You know what I mean,
I don't know, because you don't never know nigga's situation, bro. Yeah. They could have probably been plotting on that bull, and that bull turned the tables, and then didn't turn it on him.
Yeah, you never know.
You like never you know. He could have put him on game about what they was going to do. And then he got him. You know what I mean?
Yeah, he definitely said that. He was like, you don't know. Like, it's too much shit to not,
It's so much shit.
Yeah, so much shit, you know, but.
But he getting a lot of publicity in
like
this case,
like a motherfucker.
Though.
I ain't know nothing about that shit.
I never heard his songs enough.
Yeah, I seen this nigga. Why? YNW Melly. I'm like, who the fuck is this nigga? And he on trial for, I'm like, yo, that's crazy. The nigga's more famous for on trial for some shit rather than his fucking music.
His music, right? That's it's like crazy. You gotta do dumb shit to fucking get noticed. Mm-hmm. Then people start listening to your music, and then in your music, you be talking about it like, I'm going to kill my homie. I'm going to kill my homie.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You're like, damn, he really did that shit.
Yeah, but man, y'all young boys got to get smarter, man.
Tighten up.
Stop doing this dumb shit for this dumb shit.
For them clicks.
Yeah,
doing that dumb shit for these dumb clicks.
You're going to be in jail forever or dead forever.
Because when you take a life, you essentially throwing away yours. Because at some point, somebody's going to tell on you.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to get away with doing too much shit without somebody pointing the finger, buddy. So
yep, it was him.
You can only get away with it until you can't. So I don't think, you know, 5-10 years living on top of the world is worth 30 years in a box.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? What you think?
Absolutely not. But
if
hey,
if you can go back and sit for 30 years, but first you get to enjoy 10 years having 100 million, would you do it?
If I can go back 30 years.
No. If you can, you got to serve 30 years.
30
but
years?
Before you serve 30 years, you get 10 years of having 100 million. Would you do it?
Oh, fuck no.
That's all I'm saying. Because that's essentially what they doing. Yeah,
fuck no. Absolutely not. Hells to the nizzle. Them 10 years ain't going to be worth it.
Now, if you could have 100 million or live in great health till you 110, which one would you pick?
Oh, yeah. Great health till I'm 110. Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Health is more than money. Health is more than wealth.
They buy real fast. Stick that money up your ass. I can make 100 million by the time I'm 110.
At least I feel that way.
Shit.
No,
I got 100 million. Don't
be like that.
Right.
You be like, well, I still feel young, motherfucker.
100 million, bitches. I don't know.
You know what it is, the kid Buck Bandit Reno,
the boy Buck Bandit Pig,
here from the Buck Bandit Podcast, and we here to let y'all know, for all y'all entertainers, upcoming promoters, fucking entrepreneurs, you know what I mean, we got your own clothing line, no matter what you do, man,
you try and get
on the Buck Bandit Podcast. If you want to sponsor on the Buck Bandit Podcast,
get your brand out there, seen by other motherfuckers, you know what I mean? Get your shit popping out here.
Let's go, man. Hit us up. BuckBanditStudio@gmail.com.
Well, yeah. Man, shout out to everybody who been tuning in, though.
Shout out. Appreciate y'all.
Make sure you like, share, subscribe.
Yes, sir.
All that good stuff. We coming to you with bangers every week.
Bangers.
We still got more podcasts. We need to be shooting and shit, but we just getting it back rolling again.
We're getting back in rotation.
We're going to be back in.
It's coming. We getting back in rotation. Yeah. But it's coming. Oh, it's coming. Oh, it's happening, sweetheart.
But yeah, that fight definitely was a one-sided ass whooping, though.
Yeah. Ass whooping.
Shout out to T-Bud. We knew you was going to do it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
We knew.
And you already know what it is, man. Your boy Buck Bandit Reno.
Your boy Buck Bandit P.
It's been another one. Buck Bandit Podcast 86.
86.
Let's get it. Buck.
Yo, yeah, this is a crazy ass killer. You know what I'm saying? This is Hoover from Silicon Valley. This is Dwight from Dodgeball. I'm on the Buck Bandit Podcast. Chris Williams. Check it out.
Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit.
I'm tryna be richer than rich.
Hey. Okay, bitch, let's see this started. All of my niggas retarded. Pull the shit sweeper and take out the garbage. Michelangelo, I draw like an artist. Bitch, I'm in shit smell like somebody toilet. Pockets on curry, I guess that I'm ballin'. Trap phone ringin', guess somebody callin'.
Yeah, I guess somebody callin'.
Ayy, I move this shit by the low. I do this shit by the cold. Ayy, I spit this shit with my bro. Real niggas know, yeah, that's just how I go. Ayy, bosses, they do what they want. You niggas do what you told. Ayy, if you call me in, it ain't about paper. The answer is proper, so no. Nigga, don't ask me for shit. You wasn't there from the rip. Bagging up, working the whip. Mind only focus on making it flip. Call up P and tell him, nigga, we going legit. Tunnel vision for the grip, grip. All these things I might have missed. I'm making up for this shit. Yeah, I'm making up for this shit. Won't catch me loving no bitch. Won't catch me trusting no bitch. They'll set you up for a lick. Ayy, don't worry about me. Ain't stop when they made jewels to stop. It came with the kid. Ayy, I got more money to get.
I got more money to get.
Tryna get money like rich. Tryna be richer than rich.
I gotta be richer than rich.
Baby, I see this starting. All of my niggas retarded. Pull the shit sweeper and take out the garbage. Michelangelo, I draw like an artist. Bitch, I'm this shit smell like somebody toilet. Pockets on curry, I guess that I'm ballin'. Trap phone ringin', guess somebody callin'.
Yeah, I guess somebody callin'.
Ayy, I move this shit by the low. I do this shit by the cold. Ayy, I spit this shit with my bro. Real niggas know, yeah, that's just how I go. Ayy, bosses, they do what they want. You niggas do what you told. Ayy, if you call me in, it ain't about paper. The answer is probably no.
Ayy.